Okay, let us move on to the lecture now. In our previous lecture, we started to discuss about derivatives of viscose rayon. In derivatives of viscose rayon, there are two most important derivatives are there. One is the polynosic rayon and another is the tensile rayon. In the previous lecture, we discussed about what is meant by polynosic rayon. The other name of polynosic is the model which has a high modulus when compared with the normal viscose rayon. Okay, so in this process, what is the difference that we have seen in the process steps? We eliminate certain steps that we have discussed. We eliminate the use of zinc sulfate in the spinning bath. Then what do? We eliminate the aging stage. We eliminate the ripening stage also. Okay, but only difference is here, we maintain the degree of polymerization twice that of the normal viscose rayon. Okay, and another difference is, instead of dissolving in the alkali, we are using the water. Okay, the cellulose xanthate step, that is the elimination of the ripening step, we are eliminating. So this is the step which you can see. The spinning bath contains only sulfuric acid and sodium sulfate. Sulfuric acid is the regenerating agent and sodium sulfate is the salting out agent, but we do not add the zinc sulfate. Okay, so that properties we have discussed in about polynosic rayon. In the important property is that the tenacity is little higher when you compare with the viscose rayon, and degree of polymerization is twice higher than that. So comparatively, the wet strength of the polynosic rayon is higher than the normal viscose rayon. That is the to be understood. So till here we discussed in the previous lecture. So today we'll move on to the next part to be discussed. So here one thing you need to understand is the viscose rayon, though the fiber has many advantages like water absorbency, modulus and other things, it has been given up in the many countries for manufacturing process, has been given up in the many countries because of the use of the toxic pollutants, especially the alkali. When you are using the alkali that generates a lot of effluent. So that normal viscose rayon, because of the consumption of higher amount of alkali, we normally do not use the alkali. We do not want to use the alkali. Can we do some other alteration to the process so that we can manufacture the viscose rayon instead of using the alkali? So that was the thinking. So there are two different alternatives they found. One is that spinning of the solutions of the cellulose derivatives. Okay, with a subsequent saponification to yield the true cellulosic fiber. Means you are whatever dope solution that you are preparing, you will do the spinning with some additional saponification process to regenerate that cellulosic fiber. And another is direct spinning of cellulose from new organic solvents. Instead of taking the cellulose and the instead of taking the wood pulp and doing the multiple steps like steeping, shredding and aging and xanthation, filtration, ripening, if we directly take the cellulose and then dissolve it in an organic solvent, and can we do the spinning? That was the idea. So these two, among these two routes, this route was found to be much effective. So they started to use this organic solvents. Okay, so in the 1970s, there were many scientific reports to and patents and papers are published to find out whether can we use any solvent that can dissolve the cellulose and then it can regenerate the cellulose after you do the spinning. Is it possible? That was the idea. Okay, there were four solvents identified. One is that calcium thiocyanate and water, and another is ammonium thiocyanate and lithium chloride dimethyl acetamide. These are the different solvents where you can dissolve the cellulose and then you can without forming the derivative, we will directly dissolve it and then directly produce the viscose rayon. Okay, that was the objective. And finally, they have used this solvent also, N-methyl morpholine oxide, which is called MMNO or NMMO water. Okay, so here, this among these four, this solvent was found to be a much better solvent for use for manufacturing the viscose rayon. Okay, so what is this MNNO or NMMO that we are going to see? So this is a very promising solvent for and commercially successful. Okay, so cellulosic fibers, whatever regenerated cellulosic fiber that you are producing by using this organic solvent spinning process, they are known as tensil fiber or a lyocell fiber. Okay, lyocell or tensil, you can, both the names can be used. So these two are the regenerated cellulosic fiber. They are actually viscose rayon only, but a different type of a viscose rayon. Okay, so that's, we will see what is that lyocell process in detail. Okay, so here the advantage of this lyocell process is, here also we do not use the xanthation and ripening step. Okay, because xanthation, normally we use some toxic chemicals like carbon disulfide. Okay, carbon disulfide, when it gets released to environment, it creates a lot of pollution. Okay, and the ripening step also, it is a time consuming process where you have to store it for some 2-3 days to coagulate. So these two steps are eliminated here in the both the polynosic rayon also, and here also we are eliminating that step. And here we involve very few chemicals. Okay, only the NMMO solvent is the main chemical. Okay, but it is an organic solvent, and water is the universal solvent. Both you can recycle it. Okay, so the main advantage is N-methyl morpholine oxide. It is a biodegradable solvent, and it is a non-toxic, and it is a eco-friendly or environmental friendly. Okay, so how it works, that we need to understand. What is this NMMO or NMMO? This NMMO is a cyclic aliphatic tertiary amine oxide. Okay, you can see a cyclic structure here, like a benzene structure where a nitrogen, methyl group, oxygen group is there. So it is cyclic aliphatic and tertiary amine oxide. Okay, amine is there, so NCH3O. Okay, so because if you observe here, the structure contains high polar groups present here. You can see here highly polar organic amine. These amine groups with this NO bond is there. This has a high dipole moment. This can it can dissolve well because it is highly polar in nature. Okay, so this can, because of the polar region, it can form hydrogen bond with the cellulose and also with the water. It can dissolve in the water very easily. Okay, it can react with both the cellulose as well as in the water, because both contain the hydroxyl groups or the OH groups. Okay, but one thing you need to take care that you have to maintain a correct ratio of water to NMMO, because both of them, NMMO has attraction to both the water and also to the cellulose, because both contain the OH groups. Okay, so that reaction, if it reacts more with the water rather than reacting with the cellulose, then you cannot dissolve it. Okay, so that ratio you have to maintain, so that there is a competing reaction between the water and the cellulose for the NMMO molecules and water. So water should be less and NMMO should be more. Okay, that you have to take care of that. And about the properties of NMMO, what is this NMMO? NMMO is the N-methyl morpholine oxide. It is a strong oxidizing agent and a very corrosive solvent. Okay, so though it is a environmental friendly and biodegradable and it is recyclable, still it is a very strong oxidizer and very corrosive type of a solvent. It will corrode. Okay, and it has a melting point of around 170 high melting point, and it can absorb more heat around 150 degrees centigrade. So pure NMMO cannot be used as a solvent. You have to dilute that solvent. It is normally available in the names of, say, mono and dihydrate, where the hydration degrees are changed so that you reduce the melting point after you add the water. So the melting point you reduce like 74 and 35. So here, after it is added, hydrated form actually has yeah, less corrosion and less oxidation compared to the pure NMO. Okay, so here you need to make a solution of NMMO and water in that particular ratio so that you add a minor amount of water and major amount of solvent, that is the NMMO. So how do you manufacture it? Manufacturing process is much simpler and less complex when you compare with the conventional viscose rayon. Okay, where where in the conventional viscose rayon you need multiple process and some toxic process like xanthation, right, and some lengthy process like aging, ripening process. So that here the total process time is very less when you compare with the viscose rayon, which is around 40 hours. So what are the steps involved in the manufacture of lyocell? There are 5 steps. First is that you need to prepare the dope solution. Okay, dope is the spinning solution where you are going to do the spinning. Okay, that is, you will dissolve the pulp in the NMMO water mixture. And the next is the spinning. Once you dissolve it, the next step is the extrusion, where you extrude the highly viscous dope at elevated temperature with a small air gap and precipitate into a precipitation bath, like a dry jet wet spinning process you use, so that you can extrude the viscose rayon. And the next step is the coagulation of cellulose fiber. Okay, so here this coagulation is different from the coagulation actually we saw in the ripening process. So here the coagulation is very fast. It is not that kind of a time consuming coagulation which we did to find out whether it coagulated, and we went for the spinning. So this coagulation is different. Next is the post treatment, like washing, drying, post treatment, whatever is there. And the next step is the recovery of NMO, because this is a non-toxic type of a solvent and it can be recovered and then reused. Okay, so these are the 5 steps. So spinning process, before dope preparation facility, before going into spinning process. So you need 50% to 60% NMMO, okay, and 20% to 30% water, and you need to add the pulp. Good pulp you need, so that along with that you will add some antioxidants also to prevent some degradation, because this is a very highly corrosive solvent, and even it is hydrated, still there is a chance for a severe oxidation. In order to prevent that, we add the small quantity of antioxidants, okay, like N-propyl gallate. We add that so that it prevents the oxidation to some extent, so that the cellulose will not get degraded. Even if it is dissolved, it will not get degraded. Okay. So here, what you do is, you just heat it. You need to give some temperature also to dissolution. Okay, so that for example you are giving a temperature of less than 150 degrees centigrade, so that what will happen, the cellulose will dissolve in that NMMO water and other mixture, whatever antioxidant that will get dissolved, and then you can do the spinning. This is the dope preparation, and in this dope preparation, it's not a complex process, very simple process. You can see dissolving is easy. Okay. Next is the spinning process. So you add some 2-3 solution. That is why you call them as a ternary solution. Okay, binary, ternary. Ternary means 3 solutions where you add a cellulose, NMMO, and water, and you do the spinning at around temperatures of 90 to 120 degrees centigrade. Okay, so here the process is carried out using a dry jet wet spinning process. Okay, normal viscose rayon also can be carried out, is carried out only in the wet spinning process or the dry jet wet spinning process. Here also you do the same thing, and here because it is a dry jet wet spinning process, you maintain a small air gap. Okay, you know what is the use of that air gap, already I have explained you how it how important the air gap is. Okay, so here the this solvent, it is an organic solvent, so it is a more chance for evaporation. So this is actually, the process is done in a closed loop, so that most of the NMMO that it is not used in the reaction, that will be recycled and recovered, and it can be reused. So here you maintain the NMMO to water ratio of around, say, molar ratio. It is not the normal volume ratio. You maintain the molar ratio of around, say, 1:1. And spinning speeds, you maintain around, say, 100 meters per minute, because it's a wet spinning. It does not have a very high speed like a mill spinning process. So you do, you maintain this and do the spinning. You can see this is the process where the fiber formation takes place. This is the spinning. You can see here, this is the dope vessel. You can see here, okay, here this is connected with the temperature control, and here you have the spinning pump with the filter and spinnerage, and you have the spinning tube and funnel. So here here you are whatever things you require, like NMMO, water and cellulose pulp, these things you add and then heat it to certain temperature. Okay, and once you dissolve, the spinning dope is collected here, and then after filtration it is collected here, and then here you extrude, and here there is a small air gap. This air gap only you are maintaining of around 20 to 250 millimeter. Okay, and here you do the spinning, and after spinning you either take up rollers or bare where it is again immersed in a non-solvent to remove the NMMO solvent, because we do not want the NMMO after the fiber is manufactured. Okay, so here we do, we keep a non-solvent to remove the NMMO. Non-solvent can be a water, because you know well that if you keep the water, water has a more attraction to the NMMO, because both can form hydrogen bonds because of the that NO groups present, amine oxide group present. So this can be, water can be removed, and then it can pass on to the next process where some washing, rinsing, post treatment, whichever you require. If you want to do some post treatment there, you can do the post treatments, or you can do the double rinsing, and then you can collect the fiber, that is the lyocell fiber. So this is the manufacturing of lyocell or tencel fiber. It is a regenerated cellulose, but still this is a different high-end application properties it can impart when you compare with the normal viscose rayon. Okay, so what is the difference in the viscose rayon and polynosic rayon and lyocell rayon? What is the difference that we need to understand? So if you observe, this lyocell fiber has a different structural properties than that of the viscose rayon. For example, you see the normal viscose rayon has the DP of around 200, but here you see the DP is around 600. Okay, it is more, twice that of the viscose fiber. Okay, and it is highly crystalline and more oriented than the viscose rayon. So if you compare with the normal viscose rayon, the orientation is good and crystallinity is high. So what will happen? It can give good mechanical properties. Okay, and if you see the cross section of this fiber, it is having a circular cross section. Okay, but when you see the normal viscose fiber, it does not have the circular cross section. Okay, if I will show you a small figure, this is the cross section of the lyocell fiber. Okay, and here this is the cross section of the viscose rayon. If you observe this structure here, this does not have a uniform shape. It has some sort of a serrations, not uniform type of a structure it has, but whereas you see here it has a something like a oval shape. Yeah, you can see. So what is its use? Because of the cross section, it has a greater wet strength and greater tenacity, and you can see the surface is also smooth. But one thing you need to understand is here, this fiber will have certain fibrillations, means from small fibers will start protrude from the surface. When compared with the normal viscose rayon, that normal viscose rayon does not have the fibrillation. Okay, here this fiber has a good fibrillation. Okay, this fibrillation is also an advantage in certain applications. Okay, so if you observe, this fiber has a smooth surface and fibrillation is there, and absorbency, if you compare, this has a less absorbency when compared with the viscose rayon. Okay, but on the contrary, you see this fiber, lyocell fiber, has a higher wet strength, which is not there in the viscose rayon. So then what are the properties? Just compare with the properties of the all the fibers, even the cotton, because all are the cellulosic fibers. If you see, all are cellulose. Only difference is this, four are the regenerated cellulose and this is the natural cellulose. Okay, so if you see the DP, the DP of the cotton is very high, that is the degree of polymerization is very high, naturally it is produced. But if you observe for viscose rayon, it is very less, around 300, but for polynosic it is around 500, and for lyocell it is around 600, very high degree of polymerization when you compare with the other rayons. And this is one more thing, high modulus wet rayon, that is another type of rayon which we have not discussed, but that is also one of the rayon. But these two are commercially important. And if you see the water retention of viscose is very high, that is why it is used as a super absorbent fiber. Wherever you require a very high absorption of water, there you can use the viscose rayon. But whereas you see for lyocell, it is 65. If you compare with these four, you can see it is less. But whereas if you see for cotton, it is just 50, because cotton is 2/3 crystalline and only 1/3 amorphous. And the tenacity, you can appreciate that when compared with the normal viscose rayon, this has a higher tenacity. Okay, both the wet tenacity and dry tenacity is higher. But you see, but for viscose rayon, the wet tenacity is very less when you compare with the other fibers. And viscose rayon has a higher elongation, you see, higher elongation to break. But whereas for other fibers, it is not that higher. Okay, that is, there is an advantage and disadvantage for these fibers. And if you make a comparison between the lyocell fiber with the normal regenerated viscose fiber, the lyocell fiber has a higher crystallinity, longer crystallized, the crystal size polymer chains has a longer crystallites orientation than well-oriented amorphous regions. So that is the reason why it has a good dry and wet strength and high wet modulus. Okay, so because this amorphous orientation is well oriented, so that it prevents some lateral cohesion. So that what will happen, the sidewise, you see there is no cohesion, that much of a cohesion is there. So it results in a fibrillation effect. Okay, fibrillation in the sense some small fibrils will protrude from the surface. Okay, so that is the difference. This, what is the use of this fibril surface? This fibril surface, if you see, it is used for making the non-woven technical textile products and composites if you want to make. Okay, but it is not always required for a normal application. You do not want that. In case if you do not want, what you need to do, whatever fibrils are there, if you want to do not want it, then you need to add some chemicals like a cross-linking agent, so that cross-linking agent can mask these fibrils. Okay, you can add some biopolymers like chitosan or nanomaterials like silver, zinc oxide or titanium dioxide. You can add them so that apart from the normal properties, you will also get other properties like odor reducing, antibacterial properties you will get. That you will get it from any fiber if you add these things. But still, if you want to make a functional type of a lyocell fiber, you can do this. Okay, but if you want, do not want the fibrillation, then you have to add some cross-linking agent, so that fibrillation will be arrested. Okay, and what are the applications of cellulose lyocell fibers? There are many applications. Adhesive substrates in the electrical uses, you can use this. Battery separators, if you happen to see the battery, if you open it, there will be a small type of a separator that will be separating, used as a separator, that you can see. Battery separators, these fibers can be used. Filtration, yes, for filtration also this lyocell can be used. And food casings, if you want to cover the food with any kind of a food material, if you want to cover it, store it there, you can use the lyocell fiber. Flushable papers, then glass fiber binder, it can be used. Insulation papers, medical papers, napkins, tablecloths, tissue papers, reinforcement papers and security or banknote papers, tea bags. If you see the tea bag, those tea bags are also made up of some wood pulp material like lyocell. Okay, so there are multiple applications are there for the lyocell fiber when you compare with the normal viscose rayon. Okay, so this is about the derivatives of the viscose rayon. So in the derivatives of viscose rayon, there are some 3-4 types of viscose rayon is there. Like if you see cupramonium rayon is there, high wet modulus rayon is there, polynosic rayon is there, and then lyocell or the tensile fiber is there. Among all these three, this polynosic or the modal, lyocell or the tensile is commercially important to be understood. So I have given lecture on both these topics. The overview we have seen about both these fibers, the fiber manufacture, properties, and then applications. Okay, I hope you have understood today's lecture. So that's all about the derivatives of the viscose rayon.